Hello everybody. Now, so far we have seen in last slides what is meant by uninformed search, and what are the example of those uninformed search, which is BFS, DFS, DLS, bidirectional search, uniform cost search, and iterative deepening depth first search. So with an example we have seen what are the time complexity and space complexity and all those things. So if at all your requirement matches, you can choose particular searching algorithm, and depends upon your problem arrived. So next, what we are just going to see is informed search algorithm. So here in uninformed, the name itself indicate there is no prior information, there is no information available for solving a particular problem. So here in case of informed search algorithm, here there has some information about it. So if there is information, so we feel a bit easier for to solve the particular problem. So far we have talked about uninformed search algorithm, which looked through search space for all possible solutions of the problem without having any additional knowledge about the search space. But informed search algorithm contains an array of knowledge, such as how far we are from the goal, path cost, how to reach to goal node, etc. This knowledge helps agent to explore less search space and find more efficiently to the goal node. The informed search algorithm is more useful for large search space. Informed search algorithm uses the idea of heuristic, so it is called as a heuristic search. So if there is information about the particular problem, we know how to solve the particular problem. We know what way the problem going to be, what way the goal going to be. So it is easier for us to find the solution for that. Searching also bit easier for us to solve. So when there is no information in uninformed, it is difficult for us to find the search. So such a algorithm is used for a smaller search space. If there is a smaller search space where there is no information available, is also not at all a problem to consider. So they can use uninformed search. So in case of larger search space, we need to unless if we know the information, it is unable for us to find a solution. So in that cases, that kind of a problem, we can go for using this informed search algorithm. So that is what, since it uses the heuristic idea. This is the heuristic idea. That is what it is called as a heuristic search. So let me see in detail about what is meant by heuristic function. So heuristic is a function which is used in informed search, and it find the most promising path. It takes the current state of the agent as its input and produce the estimation of how close agent is from the goal. The heuristic method, however, might not always give the best solution, but it guaranteed to find a good solution in reasonable time. That is what the heuristic's main advantage is about. It's not always give a best solution, but it is guaranteed. We can guarantee that by applying this heuristic, we can give you a good solution in reasonable time. Heuristic function estimate how close a state is to the goal. It represented by h of n, that which means heuristic, and it calculates the cost of optimal path between the pair of states. The value of heuristic function is always positive. So admissibility of heuristic function is given by h of n is less than or equal to h star of n. Here h of n is a heuristic cost and h star of n is estimated cost. Hence, heuristic cost should be less than or equal to the estimated cost. That is what the heuristic main idea is about. Next, we just want to know what is a pure heuristic search. We know heuristic search is nothing but h of n less than or equal to h star of n. By having this idea, we just want to calculate. What is meant by pure heuristic, which is the simplest form of heuristic search algorithm. It expand node based on the heuristic value h of n. It maintains two lists, open and closed list. In the closed list, it places those nodes which have already expanded, and in the open list, it places node which have yet not been expanded. On each iteration, each node n with the lowest heuristic value is expanded and generate all its successors, and n is placed to the closed list. The algorithm continues until a goal state is found. So this is the main thing, what the heuristic. You don't want to confuse about how to calculate and what is meant by open and closed. In the upcoming examples, you're just going to get clear how to calculate by using this heuristic function. So heuristics mainly uses two lists, it is open and the closed list. In the closed list, what the thing going to be? The nodes which are already expanded. Got it? Already expanded, that are put in the closed list. And in open list, which doesn't expanded yet, that is will be put in the open list. So by applying this concept, by comparing this h of n less than or equal to h star of n, by having this heuristic function, it just going to calculate the heuristic search by using this heuristic. The function it get calculated and attain the goal. So this is what the main concept is about informed search. So informed search, already some information is known. By having that idea, it uses the heuristic idea in turn. By having all these ideas, it just find a solution, most promising path, where it gives the good solution rather than giving a best solution. It gives you the confirmly guaranteed to find a good solution. It might not always give a best solution. It might be give, depends upon the problem, it might give the best solution, but it may not be, for some kind of a problem, it may not be give the best solution. So, but guaranteed to be, it gives you a good solution in a reasonable time. That is what the heuristic search is, advantage of using this heuristic search. Keeping in the information, some information about the particular problem, and using the idea of the heuristic search, by comparing h of n less than or equal to h star of n, by using this function, where we know h of n is the heuristic cost and h star of n is the estimated cost. By keeping this information, that is heuristic cost always less than that or equal to the estimated cost. So by having this idea behind, it's going to solve each and every problem using this informed search algorithm. So there are two algorithms which falls into this category, so that you might get clear of what is meant by informed search algorithm. First one is best first search algorithm, and next one is A star search algorithm. So best first search algorithm, we can say it as a BFS. BFS is not about breadth first search. You should not confuse with BFS, both BFS. In uninformed search, it is BFS which is breadth first search, where it travels in breadth wise. Whereas here in informed search, BFS is called best first search. You can also name it, we can also say this as greedy search. And next comes to A star search. So these two search algorithm will follows the informed search concept by applying the heuristic function. By applying the heuristic function, it starts implementing the each and every traversing each and every node by applying this informed search algorithm. So in the next slides, we just see these two algorithm, how it follows using the informed search concept. Thank you.